batting seventh. She had a home run yesterday against the Thunder. It's a designated player, Fallon Gowrie, hitting eighth in right field, Amber Bova. And batting ninth in center field is Hannah Reese. Once again for the Fighting Muskies, it's Bavard in left with Martin at shortstop. Matthews at second base. Walker at first, Johnson at third with Hess catching. And the bottom third again has Gowrie the DP, Bova in right field, and Reese in center field. For the Thunder, leading things off and playing center field is Carly Searles. Batting second, left fielder Caitlin Clark. Kendra Marshall, the Valparaiso transfer, bats third and plays third base. The cleanup hitter is designated player Rachel Harris. Leah Hall bats fifth and plays right field. The sixth hitter is first baseman Jamie Schneier. Batting seventh and catching, the freshman Catherine Porter. Jamie Leidick hits eighth and plays second base. And the veteran from Hamilton, Ohio, is the shortstop. Batting ninth, Haley Daniels. Once again for the Thunder Blue, it's Searles in center field with Clark in left, Marshall at third base. Harris the DP with Hall on right, Schneier at first. And the bottom third again for the Thunder Blue has Porter catching, Leidick at second base, and Daniels at shortstop. Justine Robles grabs the ball for the Tryon Thunder today, a day after celebrating her 20th birthday. Had a fantastic outing against DePaul University with a 4-1 victory. Three hits, she scattered throughout the game, gave up just one earned run, which was a solo home run in the seventh inning, walked one and struck out two, and it was kind of an interesting scenario in that aspect. She struck out the first two batters of the game and did not record a strikeout the rest of the game. And then Kristen Gill from Asheville, Ohio, the sophomore, takes the ball for this Muskegon team, coming off that victory in the first round as she defeated DePaul 2-1. So neither pitcher has started against either team in the tournament, but Gill did come in yesterday and capture that save against the Thunder. Teams lined up along the baselines as we pause now for the playing of our national anthem.
Ladies, West Coast softball. The umpires at first base, Dennis Aldridge. At third base, Kim Johnson. And behind the plate on Championship Sunday, Mary Taylor.
Aaron Coyle back at the live from Tryon University getting set for softball here this afternoon in the championship round of the NCAA tournament. The Thunder and the Muskegon Muskies, the only teams left in this tournament. Muskegon is 2-0, the Thunder 2-1. So the Fighting Muskies need just one win today against the Thunder to make their ninth, or to advance on to the next round, which is a super regional. Remember, it's a different format this year. Instead of eight teams in the region, there are now four, and champions of two regions will meet for a super regional, which means you have to win the best two out of three in head-to-head competition, and the winner of that super regional advances to the NCAA championships being played this year in Tyler, Texas. trying to take in the field. Beautiful, bright, and sunny with the temperatures already in the mid-70s. Supposed to be in the upper 70s, around 80 degrees today. There is a slight chance of thunderstorms, but the prognosticators say it may come later in the day. So certainly keeping our fingers crossed. Everything right now blue and pretty with the wind blowing towards the left field line at probably 10 miles per hour. Trying with their home blue uniform tops with the white numbers outlined in Vegas gold. They have the white pants with the blue stirrups. And the Muskegon Fighting Muskies, black and magenta, their official colors. With the red tops, the black pants with the white and red striped down the side with the black batting helmets as they get set to face the California native Justine Robles from Long Beach, California. Robles attended Lakewood High School and gets her second start in as many games after she had the victory yesterday against DePaul University in that elimination game. She gets the All-American Kaylee Bavard to start things off. Left-handed hitting left fielder for the Fighting Muskies. Bavard, a captain, came in hitting .480, which is 33rd in the entire nation and 4th in the entire league. One home run, 20 RBIs, and she had a 2-run RBI base hit against the Thunder yesterday and was 2-for-3. Stands from the left side of the batter's box, has blazing speed, the All-American does. The Robles' first pitch settles up and away for a ball, and this NCAA championship round is underway. Time with their outfield a bit more shallow than they normally have it. One ball, no strike count to Bavard. It's outside again, and it is 2-0. Kaylee has had 23 games this year in which she has recorded at least two hits in the game. 2-0 pitch by Robles. It misses down and away, and she has not thrown the All-American a strike yet. Top half of the first inning, Bavard standing in the left side of the batter's box, wiggling around. The 3-0 pitch comes from Robles. It's in there for a called strike. Kaylee Bavard from Nashport, Ohio, graduated from Tri-Valley High School. Two-time first-team all-conference member and academic all-conference member. 3-1 pitch is shot foul, straight back, had a big cut, and the count fills out at 3-2. Kerry Winters, the fourth-year head coach, stands in the coaching box down the third baseline, and former Ohio Northern All-American Jackie Mangola is at the first base coaching box. Payoff pitch, he fouls it right off the glove of the catcher, Catherine Porter, as the count remains full. Trying defense today has Marshall at third with Daniels at short, Lydic second base, Schneer at first with Porter catching. As Robles sights his sign, the 3-2 again to the All-American is shot foul again, this time to the left side. Trines outer defense as Clark in left with the All-American Searles in center field and Leah Hall in right. 3-2. The All-American Bavard from the left side of the box. Robles lets loose. She fouls it off again. And a big-time at-bat to start off the championship round here today by the All-American Bavard. Muskegon founded back in 1837, a very traditional university. 3-2 pitch, swing line drive, base hit. Down the left field line, she turns on the speed but holds at first base. And Kaylee Bavard reaches the leadoff runner on for the Fighting Muskies here in the first inning.
Muskie shortstop, Kelly Martin.
And don't you forget, that's exactly how the game started yesterday. Bavard had a base hit and then Kelly Martin promptly doubled her in. Now it's Martin again from the right side of the box, wearing number 21 across her back. Had two hits, a double, and two RBIs against the Thunder a day ago. Robles grabs a sign to pitch. He bunts it right in front of the circle, barehanded by Schneer. Throws on to first base, and a great pick out of the dirt by Jamie Lydic. As Schneer had kind of an awkward angle as she was falling down as she had to throw that ball down the line. It hit the dirt, but Lydic made the pick for the out as Bavard advances to second base.
Second baseman, Jess Matthews.
3-4 sacrifice bunt by Kelly Martin. And now is Jessica Matthews, the second baseman who hit. stands on the right side of the box. Robles with the pitch. It's right down the heart of the plate for a called strike. No score first inning. Bavard at second base with one out. Jessica Matthews is 0 for 3 yesterday against Bree Fuller. Swing and a miss. Belt high fastball, and she is down two strikes. Matthews has homered twice and has driven in 14. Pitch by Robles, hangs outside a ball. Matthews is a four-year varsity player in high school from Miamisburg, Ohio. One ball, two strikes, one out. Runner at second base, first inning. 1-2 pitch, swinging a hard ground ball, base hit into right field. Here comes the runner around third. The throw to the plate is not in time.